Hey Mario, so I really want to become a model, but I think I'm just too short. It's me, Mario. So in this video, you are gonna find out if you can be a model. All right, so I published Male Model Mentor a few days ago. It's my full course on how to become a male model, step by step. And after I published it, I received so many questions from people. Do you think I'm too old to become a model? Hey Mario, I think I'm too short. Hey Mario, do you think I'm good looking enough? Do you think my nose is too big? So to answer all these questions, I made this video where I'm just gonna teach you exactly how tall you have to be and what you really have to bring in order to become a model. So let's get started. Okay, so before I can answer that question, you have to understand that modeling is not modeling. Wow, that sounded very mysterious. So what I'm trying to say with this is that there are actually three different types of modeling out there. Okay, so the first type is the oldest and also the most well-known and most prestigious type of modeling. Fashion modeling. Okay, so generally high fashion models are the models you see on the runway walking down for Gucci. And one thing you're gonna realize, high fashion models often don't look pretty in the commercial sense. They often have very big or weird ears. Some of them have eyes that are really far apart. Others have very unique features like scars or crazy tattoos all over their face. And you know, some have something really simple like a little gap between their front teeth. But they all have one thing in common. They have something unique that just stands out, something special, and something that when you see it in a picture or in a photograph, you're gonna remember that person. So that's why, especially for fashion modeling, it's not about being pretty and looking perfect. No, often it's just about being unique. And whatever imperfection you might have, you gotta understand that this is something you were born with and this is something that makes you special. And especially in fashion modeling, this can be a huge advantage. So instead of pushing your uniqueness away and trying to fit in and look like everybody else, embrace your uniqueness. If you have a scar, if you have something special, if you're not the average typical looking guy or girl, own it, embrace it, make it yours. I, for instance, hated my gap when I was a kid. I wanted to get rid of it, and now I'm so glad that I kept it because I'm realizing more and more that this is something that makes me special from other models. And I'm not kidding you, I went to so many jobs where the casting director or client told me afterwards, hey Mario, we liked a few other guys but we picked you because of your gap. So on that note, whatever you're born with, embrace it because it makes you special. And a lot of the jobs in high fashion modeling are actually on the runway where you have to walk down for a certain designer. So for those kind of jobs, I'm not gonna sugarcoated, it's very hard to get into it if you are short. I mean, there's always exceptions if you have the crazy perfect look for a designer, but generally speaking, you want to be at least 6 feet tall if you want to do high fashion or runway modeling. But the good news is that high fashion modeling is literally like 1% of the jobs out there, because most of the jobs that I do are not on the runway. I only do runway during fashion week in Milan and New York, which happens like twice a year. Most of the jobs are actually photo shoots and print jobs in the second type of modeling, which is commercial modeling. Okay, so as you can tell by the mood of my intro, commercial modeling is a lot more relatable. It's a lot more smiley. It's just about a person you will relate to. It's not about being super edgy, not about being super skinny, not about having crazy features that are gonna be memorizable. No, it's just about being likable and presentable. So commercial models are the ones you see smiling on the website of your favorite department store when you go online shopping, or they could appear on billboards or TV commercials for more mainstream brands. For example, Nike, just for mainstream products like razors, cameras, pretty much any other department store or other electronic devices. And the cool thing is that those jobs actually pay a lot more than your crazy high fashion runway shoots. They also are a lot more consistent, and most importantly, the height requirement for those jobs are less strict. So a good friend of mine from New York, for example, is very good looking. He's not the typical model type, so he would never do high fashion modeling or would never walk the runway in Milan, but he works all the time in New York. Even though he's a little bit on the shorter side, he doesn't have the typical model body, but it just looks super nice and relatable. So there are definitely a lot of opportunities for commercial modeling if you are a little bit on the shorter side. Okay, before telling you the exact requirements, I'm gonna mention one last type of modeling that's come up in the last couple of years, and that has already and is going to impact the modeling industry even more in the future. Drum roll. Instagram modeling. And Instagram models are usually not paid simply for the way they look. No, they're actually paid for the audience they bring. And you can win an audience in so many different ways. You can just be extremely nice and relatable, or cute, or smart, or cute, or inspirational. But if you bring an audience, whether it be YouTube or Google Plus or Twitter or Tumblr or Pinterest or your blog or Tinder or Snapchat or whatever other platform is gonna be out there, you will increase your chances of getting modeling jobs just because of that. So when it now comes to the big question of, can I be a model? You would first go out and look what type of modeling would be best for you. So if you were super young and skinny and you have some crazy features and you also have the height, then high fashion modeling. But be aware of the fact that for men you should be at least 6 feet tall, and for women that would be at least 5'9". And if you don't meet those requirements, you have to be honest with yourself and just realize that you're probably not gonna make it in this fashion industry. But instead you can do more relatable stuff, just be yourself, smile, take acting classes, and pursue commercial modeling. The cool thing is you can also be older for that. The lifespan for commercial modeling is also a lot longer. For fashion models, usually it's over around like 25 or something. They like this really young, fresh, edgy look. And once you get a bit older, you build more character. You might grow a beard if you're a guy. If you're a girl, I hope you don't. And you can just go out for different jobs. A lot of people also ask me about ethnicity. And maybe 20 years ago, it was true that it was mostly Caucasian models that were booked for big campaigns. But thankfully, nowadays, modeling is getting so much more diverse. So no matter if you are from Asia, if you're from Philippines, if you're from Mexico, if you're from Europe, if you're from the United States, modeling has opened up so much, and it's amazing to see that nowadays when you go to a casting for either a fashion show or a commercial shoot or TV commercial, you see different ethnicities from all over the world. And social media has become so incredibly important, not just in commercial modeling, also in fashion modeling, but also for Instagram models themselves. All right, so to sum it up, are you too short to become a model? Yes, possibly you are too short to become a high fashion runway model. And I'm gonna be honest with you, if you're too short, your chances of booking any modeling jobs will decrease dramatically. But the good thing is that social media and commercial modeling have opened up many more opportunities for models who don't meet these strict requirements. You can just be more relatable and also book more fun and consistent work. And please never make the same mistake I did of thinking that your imperfection, whatever it might be, is something that needs to be fixed. No. It is something that makes you unique, and in my case, it's landed me a lot of modeling jobs, and I'm glad I kept this. All right, so if becoming a model is something you've always wanted to do, give it a shot, but you only have one more day, because my course, Male Model Mentor, that's gonna teach you step by step how to become a male model, is gonna be taken off completely on November 1st. So you have 24 hours by the time I upload this video to get the course with all the bonuses. I'm gonna get a live coaching call where you can ask me any questions about modeling, and I'm also going to include a free ebook I wrote where I teach you my best tips and tricks on how to look good in every picture. So the link for that is going to be in the description below, and I cannot wait to get started on your journey with you. So on that note, whatever feels right to you, whatever your dream is, follow your impulse, keep smiling, and I'll see you in my next video. Yeah.